good afternoon, and welcome to this live Haas Tip of the Day. So we're just going to walk through the same setup on this UMC that we've been doing all week, but I'm going to give you an explanation of what's going on. Now, I programmed this back at the factory in California, right? I packed up my tools and the vise, I threw them in a box, and I brought them here. When it was time to run, I just loaded up my tools and pressed cycle start, right? So I have two programs, one that went ahead and touched off all of my tools, and another one that actually picks up the work offset of my part and ran it. I didn't use my indicator, I just hit cycle start. We're gonna kind of do that today. So right now, Peter's been running this part, and he actually loosened up the bolts on this vise. Now at a trade show, this is usually a really bad idea, right? Because if my work offset's not right, my machine's gonna crash. Not only that, but this is a full five-axis part. Peter's gonna go ahead and lock this thing down now, and we're gonna run the part. But on a five-axis part, normally what happens is you do the setup, you find out where the part is compared to your rotary center line, and then you post out your program from MasterCam or Fusion or whatever software you're using. That works fine, except the guy in second shift can't run the part. He might be able to set it up, but then he has to wait for the first shift programmer to come in and repost the program before he runs it. And that's just not acceptable in a lot of shops. So, I'm gonna close the door, our program's loaded, and I'm gonna press cycle start. So my probe is coming in, and right now it's just searching for the block. It's gonna find the vise because it has no idea where it's at. Then it's gonna take a couple hit points and find the angle. So if you've got a Haas rotary product right now and you're using an indicator to make this thing straight, there's nothing wrong with that, but you don't need to. You can use your probe to set that rotary offset for you. And that's what I'm doing here. It just took two hits. Again, this is so perfect. It only moved by about half a degree. So my probe came up, it rotated this thing square, and now it's picking up the real part. Now, normally on a machine, if you set up your BF2 with a vise on, you know, on another machine, all you do is use an edge finder or the probe to set your work offset, right? You make your vise straight and then you set your work offset. That's all we're doing here. But we're gonna be doing full five-axis machining. As this thing flips around, it's gonna be constantly, every millisecond, doing some math, doing the trigonometry to put the tool where it needs to go. This is just a chamfer tool coming in and tracing this part. You can see it doing a little dance. That's just letting you know that we now know where the part is. The probe found the part. Not only that, but this was written with like four lines of code, right? I programmed a square, I called up our G234 TCPC code, and then no matter what B and C axis angle I rotate to, my tool stays where it should, right at the XY in relationship to the part. What these features do, dynamic work offset and tool center point control, they allow us to program off the part no matter where it is. So if this rotates by 45 degrees and I want to move X 4 inches, it doesn't move X 4 inches this way, it moves X 4 this way, because the entire XYZ has rotated with my part. This makes it really easy to program and it makes it really easy to run. That tool's moving along pretty good. 9,000 millimeters, what is that? I keep having to do the math over and over. It's about 350, 400 meters per minute. I'll mention this now. When I chose that 40 millimeter end mill, the biggest flat on my part was a little less than 40 millimeters. So I went with a 40 millimeter shell mill. I didn't go with some big 4-inch mill, right? The smaller the tool I can go with, that means the higher the RPM I can go with, right? So I want to run 15,000 RPMs, not 5,000 RPMs. Higher RPM means higher feed rate. Once I decided on 40 millimeter, I found the tool that had the most number of inserts, right? 6-7 inserts. So now I can go really high RPM with 6 or 7 inserts, so I can crank through material at 500 or 600 inches per minute, right? So bigger is not always better, right? Just so you know, check out the parts that you're running. Don't run a bigger, you know, tool than you need to sometimes, because that means you have to go a slower RPM. These are the kind of tips we're giving on our Haas Tip of the Days on YouTube. We ran a TSC drill, tool center point, and now we've got a picture on the screen showing us 15,000 RPM spindle. So where do these pictures come from, right? This is a trade show, right? So we're kind of displaying trade show sales type stuff on my screen, you know? 15,000 RPM, through spindle coolant, TSC. But in your shops, you'd want to display setup information, right? So I was mentioning this earlier. You could display a picture called bob.jpg. And if Bob keeps scrapping parts because he's not measuring the bore on his parts, then right in your program, you could call up a little picture called bob.jpg. You could put Bob's picture up here and say, Bob, check the bores on your parts. You've scrapped 12 parts this week. And that picture doesn't even have to be on the machine. All Bob has to do is load his normal NC file onto the machine. And from within the G-code program, you can call up any picture, PDF, or movie with a simple M120 call, an M120 media M code. So M120, open parentheses, bob.jpg, and it's going to call up that picture. Now that picture can reside on your network or on your laptop, the hard drive, the USB. This tool is finishing up. It just finished the face mill there. And again, it flipped over 90 degrees. How does it know where the part is? I don't care, right? I just don't care. I program as if my world was this. All I have to know about is the part. All these other angles and rotations, the machine takes care of. Once when the machine is installed, you use a programming routine on a gauge ball, on a magnetic base, and the machine finds the center line of the rotary axis. From then on, all you have to do is pick up the work offset, just like you would on a VF2. Right now my chamfer tool is running. When this part finishes, when this tool finishes, it's gonna come up and do a tool change with the probe. Get it ready for the next operation. One thing with a Haas machine, you don't want to turn off your coolant with an M9. You don't want to stop your spindle with an M5. You don't have to. These things take time if you do them one at a time. What you want to do is just call up an M6 and the tool, the machine, will turn off the coolant, stop the spindle, move directly to the tool change position, and it'll do all those things at once. That can save me like, you know, 2 or 3 seconds per tool change. On a part like this, that's like 40 seconds per part. It's a big deal. So if you have a Haas machine today, look through your programs, get rid of your M5s, those spindle stops. Get rid of those M9s, right? Just call up your M6 tool change. The machine will turn off the coolant, stop the spindle automatically, and it'll do those things simultaneously, and that's gonna save you time. Right there, that tip, right, should save you cycle time when you go home. So this thing stopped at an M0, which is telling me to change the part. Not only that, but it played a video. There was an M120 video showing us how to change this part. My boss filmed this on Sunday on his cell phone. We load the file onto the network, and there you go. We're all set. Well, that's it. And thanks for watching this live Haas Tip of the Day.